Okay, guys, so today I want to talk about, two major milestones that I'm personally dealing with at home, and I'm going to vent a little bit. And also, I want to get your advice and maybe some tips that you might have. So parents, if you're watching, this is basically for you. Obviously, Aza and Maxon are growing every single day. They're 17 months old right now, and we have already gotten rid of the bottles. It's funny because I actually think I had a harder time saying goodbye to the baby bottles than they did. We are fully on sippy cups now, and they seem to have no issue with it. But I did. I think it was just this feeling of like, oh my gosh, they're no longer babies. Like they literally don't need their baby bottles anymore. So I got rid of most of the baby bottles, and I say most because I kept four. And I really don't know why I kept them, but in my brain, I guess I kind of just thought, well, maybe they'll come in handy if like an emergency situation happens or I need to soothe them, which actually it kind of did the other day. Aza got her little finger stuck in the door because, well, I'm gonna go off topic a little bit, but Maxon loves shutting doors right now. I don't know what it is, but if he sees a door that's open, you better watch yourself because he's gonna come and he's gonna slam it. And obviously we're trying to tell him that, no, you shouldn't do that, it's bad. So that's what happened the other day. Aza had her hand around the door frame and he just went and pushed it and her little finger got smashed. It was bad. Obviously she's crying hysterically at her. It turned blue. I'm freaking out. I'm holding back the tears because I really can't handle when they get hurt. But my first instinct was to go to the cabinet and get a baby bottle and fill it with milk because I felt like it would soothe her because it would just be like, I don't know, it would just did. And actually it kind of did work. So that's why I'm keeping the baby bottles. But how did you do it? When do you actually get rid of them completely? Would love some of those tips. Now, on to the major one. And I actually put this on Instagram the other day and you guys gave me a few good tips. And it's weaning off of the pacifier. Right now, we're trying to make it so that they just have their pacifiers when they take naps and when they go to bed at night, but not if they're just hanging out in the house. If they're playing with their toys, I try to just not have them with their pacifiers, but they'll fight me every now and then. And if they get cranky, it's like my first instinct is just to give them a pacifier because, I mean, let's face it, it shuts them up. So I was trying to figure out what the best way to go about this was, and I got a few good tips, but if you guys have any more, please, 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 please comment below and let me know. Just some that kind of stood out was to cut the tip, which I haven't tried that yet, but I guess cutting the tip, eventually they're like, what is this? This sucks. And they will just not want the pacifier. And then another one was to show them, like basically have them physically throw the pacifier away. So like bring all of them to the trash can and make it like a game. Like, okay, we're saying bye-bye to the pacifier. And then you kind of just make them do it so that they know that it's completely done and over with. But also deep down inside, I'm like, oh, then they're not gonna have pacifiers anymore. But anyways, comment below, let me know. Would love your advice, always love your tips. And until next time.